So national disaster management. So what is a disaster? Now it must have been used to, right? That is, it means any catastrophe, any dangerous, any mishap, any calamity or grave occurrence in any area arising from natural or man-made causes or by accident or negligence which results in substantial loss of life or human suffering or damage to and destruction of property or damage to or degradation of environment and of such a nature and magnitude as to be beyond the coping capacity of the community of the affected area. Every time when mentioning about this definition, you know, you have to mention this last line, that is, which is beyond the coping capacity of the affected community, correct? Then all these things we have seen, that is different types of disasters. So like you have classified into different groups, that is water and climate related hazards, or of course when they lead to disasters, geological related hazards, chemical, industrial, nuclear related disasters. Okay, so water and climate related hazards are flood and drainage management, cyclones, tornadoes, hurricanes, hailstorms, cloudbursts, snow avalanche, heat and cold waves, thunder and lightning, sea erosion, droughts. Okay, so all this we have seen in the previous modules as well. This is just a revision for you. Geological related hazard, that is earthquake, landslides, mud flows, soil erosion, dam burst, dam failures, mine fires, then chemical, industrial or nuclear related disaster, that is chemical and industrial disasters, nuclear disasters. Then you have accident related disasters, correct? That is road, rail or other transportation accidents, including waterways, of course, airways, mine flooding, major building collapse, serial bomb blasts, festival related disasters, urban fires, oil spills, village fires, boat capsizing upside down, correct? Forest fires, electrical disasters and fires. Then you have biological related disasters, like biological disasters, food poisoning, cattle epidemics or pest attacks, okay? So these are the different types of disasters. So what is disaster? What are the different types of disasters? How they are classified into different groups? And then disaster management, which is nothing but a continuous and integrated process. It is a continuous process because you have pre-disaster, post-disaster and during disaster phases as well. Okay, so it means the continuous and integrated process of planning, organizing, coordinating and implementing the measures which are necessary for or expedient, that is required for prevention for danger of any threat of any disaster, mitigation or reduction of the risk. Correct? These are all the phases that we have seen in the whole disaster management cycle. That is prevention, mitigation, capacity building, preparedness, okay, prompt response to any threatening situation, assessing the severity or magnitude, evacuation, rescue and relief, rehabilitation and reconstruction. Okay, so all these come under the disaster management. This also we have seen in the previous modules. Okay. So this disaster management continuum is a continuous process. Okay, it is a cycle, means it's a continuous process. Then who manages it and how? So yesterday in the previous lecture, we had seen the institutional framework. Okay, so those are the people who manage it. Okay, and how the roles and responsibilities are given to each and every department. Correct? So Disaster Management Act 2005, it was established on 23rd December 2005. Then NDMA was established under this act, that is National Disaster Management Authority. The chairperson of NDMA is Prime Minister. Now I have repeated this, all these things many times, so it should be fit in your mind. Okay, so Prime Minister is the chairperson of NDMA and 8 other members nominated by chairperson and other supporting staff. Chairperson can also nominate one as vice chairman. National Executive Committee, which includes Secretary to the Government of India, who hold the administrative charge of the disaster management, acting as chairperson along with the secretaries of Agriculture, Atomic, Energy, Defense, Water, Environment, Forest, Finance, Health, Power, Rural Development, Science and Technology, Space Telecommunication, Urban Development, and Chief of the Integrated Defense Staff along with the supporting staff. Then The National Disaster Management Authority may constitute advisory committee, which includes the expert from the various disaster field. Okay, similarly, the National Executive Committee can constitute other subcommittees also for better functioning of the process. Then, see, these are the roles of NDMA. Okay, that is, yesterday also we have seen it in brief. These are point wise, if at all it comes in the exam, the roles, the responsibilities, the functions of NDMA. Okay, so you should write it down in this, you can write it down in such points. That is, lay down the policies on disaster management. Okay, approve the national plan. Then approve the plans prepared by ministries or departments of the government of India in accordance with the national plan. Correct. Then lay down the guidelines to be followed by the state authorities in drawing up the state plan. Correct. Yesterday also we have seen this. Then lay down the guidelines to be followed by different ministries or departments of the government of India for the purpose of integrating the measures for prevention of the disaster or the mitigation of its effects in their development plan and projects. Coordinate the enforcement and implementation of the policy and plan for disaster management. Recommend provision of funds for the purpose of mitigation. Provide such support to other countries affected by major disasters as may be determined by the central government. Correct? As we require support from international agencies during our disaster situation, of course we also have to support, or we do support the other countries affected by disasters. So that is all managed by the NDMA. Take such measures for the prevention of disaster or the mitigation of preparedness and capacity building for dealing with the threatening disaster situation or disaster as it may consider necessary. Lay down the broad policies and guidelines for the functioning of National Institute of Disaster Management. So these are the roles of NDMA. Then, the national authority shall recommend guidelines for the minimum standard of relief to be provided to person affected by disaster, which shall include the minimum requirement to be provided in the relief camp in relation to shelter, food, drinking water, medical cover and sanitation. The special provision to be made for widows and orphans. The ex gratia, the finance assistance on account of loss of life, as also assistance on account of damage to houses and for restoration of means of livelihood. Okay, so this guidelines for the same is also provided by the national authority. Okay, that is the minimum standards or minimum whatever relief to be provided to the affected people. The national authority, that means the same National Disaster Management Authority. Then roles of National Executive Committee. So as you know, after NDMA, okay, under that you have National Executive Committee. So the National Executive Committee, NEC, it acts as a coordinating and monitoring body for disaster management. It prepares the national plan to be approved by the national authority. Correct? Approves the national plan is the role of the NDMA, but preparing of the national plan is from the NEC. Coordinate and monitor the implementation of the national policy. Lay down the guidelines for preparing disaster management plan by different ministries of the department of the government of India and the state authorities. Provide necessary technical assistance to the state government and the state authorities for preparing their disaster management plans in accordance with the guidelines laid down by the national authority. Wherever this national authority word comes, it's nothing but NDMA, National Disaster Management Authority. Monitor the implementation of the national plan and plans prepared by the ministries or departments of the government of India. Monitor the implementation of the guidelines laid down by the national authorities for integrating of measures for prevention of the disasters and mitigation by the ministries or departments in their development plans and projects. Monitor, coordinate and give direction regarding the mitigation and preparedness measures to be taken by different ministries or departments and agencies of the government. Evaluate preparedness at all government levels for the purpose of responding to any threatening situation or disaster and give directions where necessary for enhancing such preparedness. Plan and coordinate specialized training program for disaster management for different levels of officers, employees and voluntary rescue workers. Coordinate response in the event of any threatening disaster situation or disaster. Lay down the guidelines for or give direction to the concerned ministries or the departments of the government of India, the state government, and the state authorities regarding measures to be taken by them in response to any threatening disaster situation or disaster. Then NEC may require any department or agency of the government to make available to the national authority or state authority such men or material resources as are available with it for the purpose of emergency response, rescue and relief. Then NEC advises, assists and coordinates the activities of the ministries or departments of the government of India, state authorities, statutory bodies, other governmental and non-governmental organizations and other engaged in disaster management. It provides necessary technical assistance or give advice to the state authorities and district authorities for carrying out their functions under this act. It promotes general education and awareness in relation to disaster management and it performs such other functions as the national authority may require it to perform. Okay, so these are the roles of National Executive Committee, who is just next to NDMA. Okay, so these roles you have to remember in case it comes in the exam. So it's easy to remember since it's point wise, and if you go through the roles once, you can actually write it down easily and remember it easily. Then, now this National Disaster Management Plan, which is prepared from the NEC and approved by the NDMA, what it should include? The National Disaster Management Plan shall include measures to be taken for the prevention of disasters or the mitigation of their effects. Correct? So it should include measures to be taken for prevention or mitigation. Either if you could prevent the disaster from happening, or if the disaster is happening, then how you can reduce the effect of it. So measures for that. Then it shall include measures to be taken for integration of mitigation measures in the development plans. It shall include measures to be taken for preparedness and capacity building to effectively respond to any threatening disaster situation or disaster. Then it shall include the roles and responsibilities of different ministries or the department of the government of India in respect to specified clauses, that is A, B, C. Okay, so measures for prevention, measures for mitigation, measures for preparedness, capacity building. So for these clauses, which are the different ministries or departments of the government who are responsible for it, that also has to be included in this plan. Okay, then this plan has to be reviewed and updated annually, of course. Okay, because the situation is not same every year, so it has to be reviewed and updated annually. Then, like you have NDMA, like we have seen NDMA, National Disaster Management Authority, you have SDMA, that is State Disaster Management Authority, or it is also called as State Management Authority, SMA, or SDMA for you to easily remember. So, like yesterday we had seen, NDMA has the chairperson who is no one but Prime Minister. Same way here, SDMA, the chairperson is the Chief Minister. So in the SDMA, it consists of Chief Minister, who is the chairperson, other 8 members nominated by him, and the chairperson of the State Executive Committee along with the supporting staff. Chairperson may designate the vice chairperson, and it may constitute the advisory committee, which may include field expertise along with the supporting staff. Similar like at the national level, it is at the state level. You have at the state level you have chief minister as the chairperson, and you have the state executive committee like you have the national executive committee. So state executive committee, it includes chief secretary as the chairperson along with four secretaries which state government thinks that are important along with the supporting staff. The state executive committee may constitute further subcommittees if required. Now, the roles of SDMA. Like we had seen the roles of NDMA, you have roles of SDMA. Now I will tell you how to remember this, or you know how to relate it. If you see here, see the roles of NDMA. Okay, so what were there? Lay down the policies, approve the national plan, approve the plans made by the ministries or departments of the government of India in accordance with the national plan, lay down the guidelines to be followed by the state authorities. So I'll just relate. See, lay down the state disaster management policy, approve the state plan, approve the disaster management plan prepared by the departments of government of the state, lay down the guidelines followed by the departments, okay, for and coordinate an implementation of the state plan. See, monitor is the implementation of the national plan. Okay, so whatever responsibilities are there at the coordinate the enforcement and implementation of the policy and plan. Okay, so whatever the roles are there at the national level, the similar are the roles of SDMA but at the state level. Okay, so lay down the state disaster management policy, approve the state plan in accordance with the guidelines laid down by the national authority, approve the disaster management plan prepared by the departments of the government of the state, lay down the guidelines to be followed by the department of the government of the state for the purpose of integration of measures for prevention of disasters and mitigation in their development plans and projects and provide necessary technical assistance. Therefore, coordinate the implementation of the state plan, recommend the provision of funds for mitigation and preparedness measures, review the development plans of the different departments of the state and ensure that prevention and mitigation measures are integrated therein, review the necessary measures being taken for mitigation capacity building and preparedness by the department of the government of the state and issue such guidelines as may be necessary. So these are the roles of SDMA, which are in line with the roles of NDMA. Okay, same way you have role of SEC, which are in line with the roles of NEC. Okay, see, act as the coordinating monitoring body, prepare the national plan, coordinate and monitor the implementation of the national policy, lay down the guidelines. Just a second. See, lay down the state disaster management policy, approve the state plan. Coordinate and monitor the implementation of the national policy, the national plan and the state plan, examine the vulnerability of different parts of the state to different forms of disaster and specify the measures to be taken for their prevention and mitigation, lay down the guidelines for preparation of disaster management plan by the department of the government of the state and district authorities, monitor the implementation of the disaster management plans prepared by the department of the government of the state and district authorities, monitor the implementation of the guidelines laid down by the state authority. Okay, so guidelines are given by SDMA, but monitoring the implementation of it is to be done by SEC. Similar, this is for state level, similar is for national level. The guidelines at the national level are given by NDMA. But monitoring the implementation, is there proper implementation of those guidelines? Okay, so that monitoring is to be done by NEC at the national level. Okay, so the roles of SEC, that is monitor the implementation of the guidelines laid down by the state authority, for integrating of measures for prevention of disasters and mitigation by the department in their development plans and projects. Evaluate preparedness at all governmental or non-governmental levels to respond to any threatening disaster situation or disaster, and give directions where necessary for enhancing such preparedness. Coordinate the response in the event of any threatening disaster situation or disaster. Give direction to any department of the government of the state or any other authority or body in the state regarding actions to be taken in response to any threatening disaster situation or disaster. Then, promote general education, awareness and community training in regard to the forms of disaster to which different parts of the state are vulnerable and measures that may be taken by such community to prevent the disaster, mitigate and respond to such disasters. Then, advise, assist, these are again all the roles. We are continuing with the roles of state executive committee. So it advises, assists and coordinates the activities of the department of the government of the state, district authorities and statutory bodies and other governmental and non-governmental organizations engaged in disaster management. Then SEC provides necessary technical assistance or give advice to district authorities and local authorities for carrying out their functions effectively. It advises the state government regarding all the financial matters in relation to disaster management. It examines the construction in any local area in the state, and if it is of the opinion that the standards laid for such construction for the prevention of disaster is not being or has not been followed, it may direct the district authority or the local authority, as the case may be, to take such action as may be necessary to secure the compliance of such standards. So see, the roles are very important of SEC. It provides information to the national authority, that is NDMA, relating to the different aspects of disaster management. It lay down and review and update the state level response plans and guidelines and ensure that the district level plans are prepared, reviewed and updated. It ensures the communication system are in order and the disaster management drills are carried out periodically. The practices of disaster management, that is, which is called the disaster management drills. Then performs such other functions as may be assigned to it by the state authority or as it may consider necessary. So these are the roles of SEC, that is State Executive Committee, which is just next to SGMA. Now, there shall be a plan for disaster management for every state, which is called the State Disaster Management Plan. Correct? Like at national level, you have a National Disaster Management Plan. So there has to be a plan at every state level also, which is called the State Disaster Management Plan or just the State Disaster Plan. So what this plan should include? We have seen what the National Disaster Management Plan should include. Same way now, what state plan prepared at every state should include? The state plan shall include the vulnerability of different parts of the state to different forms of disasters, the measures to be adopted for prevention and mitigation of disasters, the manner in which mitigation measures shall be integrated with the development plans and projects, the capacity building and preparedness measures to be taken, the roles and responsibilities of each of the department of the government of the state in relation to the measures specified in the clauses B, C and D. Correct? Same way it was there in national plan also. The measures for prevention, measures for mitigation, the measures for capacity and preparedness. So who are the department of the state government who will be taking these responsibilities? So that has to be mentioned. Okay. Then the roles and responsibilities of different departments of the government of the state in responding to any threatening disaster situation or disaster. And the state plan shall be reviewed and updated annually. If you see this and the national plan, they are in line. The first point, that is the vulnerability of different parts of the state to different forms of the disaster. Because the analysis is easier at state level, correct? So that is to be included. Otherwise, if you see, the other things are similar to the national plan. It's just that those were at the national level, the committee is responsible at the national level, and here state, it is at the state level. Then after SJMA, that is at national level, you have NDMA, National Disaster Management Authority. At state level, you have SDMA, State Disaster Management Authority. Same way, when you come down again, at district level, you have District Disaster Management Authority, which is nothing but DDMA. Okay? So, it consists of the collector or the district magistrate or the deputy commissioner who will be the chairperson. Okay? So, here the chairperson could be collector or district magistrate or deputy commissioner, whoever will be appointed. Then elected representative of the local authority will be the co-chairperson. Okay, by election, whoever will be the person from the local authority, he will be the co-chairperson. Then chief executive of the district authority, chief executive officer, he will be additional collector or additional district magistrate or additional deputy commissioner. Anyone out of them will be the chief executive officer. Okay, and then you have superintendent of the police, then you have CMO, and where Zila Parishad is in place. Okay, and where Zila Parishad is in place, chairperson of the Zila Parishad will be co-chairperson along with the supporting staff. Okay, now if you know what is the full form of CMO, let me know in the chat section. If you know what is the full form of CMO, I will tell you at the end. Then, so now roles of DDMA, like we have seen the roles of NDMA and we have seen the roles of SDMA, similar is the role of DDMA. Okay, so prepare a disaster management plan including disaster response plan for the district, coordinate and monitor the implementation of the national policy, state policy, national plan, state plan and district plan. Ensure that the areas in the district are vulnerable to disasters that are identified, and measures for the prevention of the disasters and the mitigation of its effects are undertaken by the department of the government at the district level as well as by the local authorities. Ensure that the guidelines for prevention of the disasters, mitigation of its effect, preparedness and response measures as laid down by the national authority and the state authority are followed by all the department of the government at the district level and the local authorities in the district. Give direction to different authorities at the district level and the local authorities to take such measures for the prevention or mitigation of the disasters as may be required. Lay down the guidelines for prevention of disaster management plans by the department of the government at the district level and the local authorities in the district. Monitor the implementation of the disaster management plan prepared by the department of the government at the district level. So same way, as I compared you with the roles of SDMA and NDMA, if you compare the roles of DDMA, they are in line. They all are in line, that is similar, but just the difference is they are at a different level. So when you are talking about DDMA, it is in relation to the district level and the local authorities. Then, the more responsibilities of DDMA are lay down the guidelines, to be followed by the department of the government at the district level for the purpose of integration of the measures for prevention of the disasters and mitigation in their development plans and projects, and provide necessary technical assistance therefore. Monitor the implementation of the measures referred in the clause above. Then review the state of capabilities for responding to any disaster or threatening disaster situation in the district, and give direction to the relevant departments or authorities at the district level for their upgradation as may be necessary. Then review the preparedness measures and give direction to the concerned departments at the district level or other concerned authorities where necessary for bringing the preparedness measures to the levels required for responding effectively to any disaster or threatening disaster situation. Organize and coordinate specialized training programs for different levels of officers, employees, and voluntary rescue workers in the district. Facilitate community training and awareness programs for prevention of disaster or mitigation with the support of local authorities, governmental and non-governmental organizations. Set up, maintain, review and upgrade the mechanism of early warnings and dissemination of proper information to the public. Prepare, review and update the district level response plan and guidelines. Coordinate response to any threatening disaster situation or disaster. Ensure that the departments of the government at the district level and the local authorities prepare their response plan in accordance with the district response plan. Now, if you see, the roles at the district level are very core and very important, because it's at that level the major activities are going to be performed on field activities. Okay. So that is why the roles or the authority at the district level, the local authority, are very important. Then there are still more roles of DDMA, that is, lay down the guidelines or give direction to the concerned department at the district level or any other authorities within the local limits of the district to take measures to respond effectively to any threatening disaster situation or disaster. Advise, assist and coordinate the activities of the department of the government at the district level, statutory bodies and other governmental and non-governmental organizations in the district engaged in the disaster management. Coordinate with and give guidelines to local authorities in the district to ensure that the measures for the prevention or mitigation of threatening disaster situation or disaster in the district are carried out promptly and effectively. Provide necessary technical assistance or give advice to the local authorities in the district for carrying out their functions. Review development plans prepared by the Department of the Government at the district level, statutory authorities or local authorities, with a view to make necessary provisions therein for prevention of disaster or mitigation. Examine the construction in any area in the district, and if it is of the opinion that the standards for the prevention of the disaster or mitigation laid down for such construction is not being or has not been followed, may direct the concerned authority to take such action as may be necessary to secure the compliance of such standard. That is, it has to match with the standards. If any preparedness or mitigation measure or any construction activities required to deal with that disaster is not according to the standards, and identify the buildings and places which could, in the event of any threatening disaster situation or disaster, be used as relief centers or camps, and make arrangements for water supply, sanitation in such buildings or places. Then establish the stockpiles of relief. Okay, all the required content of relief and rescue material, or ensure preparedness to make such materials available at short notice. Provide information to the state authority relating to different aspects of disaster management. Encourage the involvement of non-governmental organizations and voluntary social welfare institutions working at the grassroots level in the district for disaster management. Ensure communication systems are in order and disaster management drills are carried out periodically. Perform such other functions as the state government or the state authority may assign it to or it deems necessary for disaster management in the district. So this is, if you see, it is actually the roles of DDMA plus the chief executive officer combined. Okay, then there shall be a plan for disaster management for every district of the state. correct? As you have plan at national level, you have plan at the state level. Similarly, there is a plan, there has to be a plan at every district level to be made. The district plan shall be prepared by the district authority after consultation with the local authorities and having regard to the national plan and the state plan to be approved by the state authority. Now, what should this district plan should include? Like we have seen, what the national plan should include, what the state plan should include. Similarly, what this district plan shall include? It should include the areas in the district vulnerable to different forms of disaster, the measures to be taken for prevention and mitigation of the disaster by the department of the government at the district level and local authorities in the district, the capacity building and preparedness measures required to be taken by the department of the government at the district level and the local authorities in the district to respond to any threatening disaster situation or disaster, the response plans and procedures in the event of a disaster, providing for allocation and of responsibilities to the department of the government at the district level and local authorities in the district. Okay, it should also provide prompt response to disaster and relief thereof, procurement of essential resources, establishment of communication links, and the dissemination of information to the public, such other as may be required by the state authority. District plan shall be reviewed annually and updated annually, reviewed and updated annually. Okay, they are also, this district plan is also, if you see, it is in line with the national plan and the state plan, but since it is at a district level, a very grassroots level, the responsibilities or the plan should include the measures taken at the grassroots level where actually the disasters are happening. Then similar like you have the district level, below that you have the office or what you call it as the local level, the local authorities, the regional. Okay, so every office of the government of India and of the state government at the district level and the local authorities shall subject to the provision of the district authority. Okay, every office of the government, every local office of the government. Okay, then at local level or at the office level, what are the roles done? That is, prepare the disaster management plan, setting out the following, namely provision for prevention and mitigation measures as provided for in the district level, I mean district plan, and as assigned to the department or agency concerned. Okay, provision for taking measures relating to capacity building and preparedness as laid down in district plan, the response plan and procedures in the event of any threatening disaster situation or disaster, coordinate the preparation. See, if you see the roles at the local level, so the first is the prepare the disaster management plan, setting out the following. So the disaster management plan at the local level should include all this. There is provision for prevention and mitigation measure, provision for taking measures for capacity building, the response plan and procedures. Okay, then what are the other roles? Coordinate the preparation and the implementation of its plan with those of the other organization at the district level, including the local authorities, communities, and other stakeholders, other organizations which come together in helping to deal with this disaster situation. So that is also coordinating, that is also the role at the local level. Regularly review and update the plan at that level, submit the copy of his disaster management plan and of any amendment, any changes made in it to the district authority. Okay, so these are the roles at the local level. Okay, so as I told you, if you know the full form of CMO, do let me know in the chat section. The CMO is nothing but Chief Medical Officer. So we will stop our lecture today here. In the next lecture, we will have a brief about NIDM and a brief about NDRF. Okay, so these are the roles and responsibilities point wise that you should remember, and what individual plan at individual level should include. Okay, that you should remember.